Hey guys, welcome to another computer graphics tutorial. Guys, before starting with the tutorial, I would like to request you to make sure that you subscribe to my channel. Second thing, make sure that you watch this video completely, as I'm going to take an example also while explaining this. So make sure you watch this video completely. Third thing, if you have any doubts, don't worry, ask them in the comment section below. I'll reply as soon as possible. And if you like this video, hit that like button and share this video with your friends. So let's get started. First, we'll cover the basics. Okay, the Digital Differential Analyzer is a scan conversion line algorithm based on calculating either the dx or dy or delta x or delta y. Second point is, very important formula for DDA algorithm is the formula of slope. Slope is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, or it also means that slope is equal to y end minus y start divided by x end minus x start. It means that you have to subtract from the end y coordinate the starting y coordinate divided by end x coordinate minus the x start coordinate. Okay, for example, over here, let's say we have a line and starting point is 2, 1 and ending point is 3, 4. So how we find the slope? We have the same formula, y end minus y start upon x end minus x start. Okay, so what is the y end point? Y end coordinate 4. Okay, what is the y starting coordinate? 1. Okay, so 4 minus 1 divided by, what is the starting coordinate of x? It is 2. And what is the ending coordinate of x, or ending x coordinate? It is 3. So 3 minus 2. So what is the slope that we get? We get, in this case, slope is equal to 3. All right, so to sample the full line, we sample it at unit intervals by incrementing in one coordinate and then computing the other coordinate. So if you didn't understand this, we'll look at an example, then you'll understand. If the slope of the line m, okay, how we represent slope with m, so if m is less than or equal to 1, then to compute the point, we use this formula, xk plus 1 is equal to xk plus 1, that is the previous coordinate, plus 1. You add 1 to the previous value. And then how we get y, next y coordinate, or yk plus 1? Yk plus 1 is equal to yk plus m. Now, how I got these formulas, that I will explain in the next part. Okay, if the slope, so this was the case when m was less than or equal to 1. Okay, and in case the m or the slope is less, is greater than 1, then to compute next coordinate point, we use these formulas, xk plus 1, that is the next x coordinate, will be equal to xk plus 1 by m. Okay, so you add to the previous value 1 by m. Okay, and to find yk plus 1, that is the next y coordinate, what you do, you just add 1 to the previous coordinate, that is yk plus 1. Okay, so let's see what is the algorithm for this. If the slope is m less than 1, okay, we sample it at unit x interval. So that is, we increment by dx, that is the difference between the x coordinates will be 1, and compute the successive y coordinate. So what we do, we just increment the x coordinate by 1 and then we find the next y coordinate with the slope formula. So like this. So we know the the slope is less than 1. So what we do? We increment the x by 1. So difference between the x coordinate is 1. So xk plus 1 is equal to xk, that is the previous coordinate, and you add 1 value. Now we substitute this to find the value of yk plus 1. So we know the formula. M is equal to delta y upon delta x. It means the same. Y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, it means the same, or y end minus y start upon x end minus x start, it all means the same. Slope formula is just the same, representation forms are different. Okay, so in our case, when m is less than 1, we know the value of delta x, that is the difference between x coordinates, which is 1. We don't know the difference between the y coordinates, so we just write yk plus 1, that is the next coordinate, minus yk divided by, in our case, the difference between axis or x coordinate is 1. So we just write 1. So we just multiply 1 over here and then rearrange this equation. What do we get? Yk plus 1 is equal to m, this minus will go here and become plus, so m plus yk. Okay, so therefore when m is less than 1, what is the coordinate of the next value, or what is the value of the next coordinate? Xk plus 1 will become xk plus 1, and yk plus 1 will become yk plus m. So that's how we get this value. Okay, this xk plus 1 is equal to xk plus 1 and yk plus 1 is equal to yk plus m. That's how we get it. Okay, now this is about how we get for m less than 1. What if the slope is greater than 1? Okay, if the slope is greater than 1, what we do is we sample the unit y, that is we just increment the y coordinate by 1. Okay, so therefore we know the delta y or dy as 1, and therefore yk plus 1 will become yk plus 1. Now we substitute this to find the xk plus 1. Similarly, what we did over there, we are going to do it with the y coordinate now. So m is equal to delta y upon delta x. Okay, and m is equal to, since we know the value of delta y, which is difference is 1, so you just write 1 over here below, we just write yk plus 1 xk plus 1 minus xk. Okay, so we just rearrange this and send this xk plus 1 minus xk on the other side is equal to 1 upon m. Rearrange this and send this xk minus xk on the other side, it becomes plus xk. So we know the value of xk plus 1 as xk plus 1 by m. Therefore, when m is greater than 1, what happens is xk plus 1, that is the next coordinate, becomes xk, that is previous coordinate, plus 1 by m. And yk plus 1 becomes yk plus 1, that is the previous coordinate, plus 1. Okay, so what happens when m is equal to 1, that is the slope is 1, therefore x, delta x and delta y are 1, so 1 by 1 is 1, so yk plus 1 becomes yk plus 1 and xk plus 1 becomes xk plus 1. This is very simple. Over here we just increment both the y coordinate and x coordinate by 1. Okay, that's how we do it for when m is equal to 1. Now we'll take a look at the summary over here. So when m is less than 1, x coordinate is xk plus 1, next x coordinate. Okay, and next y coordinate is yk plus m. When m is equal to 1, next x coordinate is xk plus 1 and next y coordinate is yk plus 1. And when m is greater than 1, xk plus 1 is equal to xk plus 1 by m and yk plus 1. Okay, so this is how we get the next x and y coordinates. Okay, this is the summary. Just take a look at this. Alright, now with solve an example, you will understand it much more clearer. Okay, now first, this is the line. Simple, same example we have taken. Okay, 2,1 and 3,4 are the two endpoints. Okay, now what we'll do is first we'll find the slope. How we find the slope? Y end minus y start upon x end minus x start. So over here y end minus y start is what? 4 minus 1. Okay, that becomes 3. And x end minus x start, that is 3 minus 2. So that is 1. So it becomes 4 minus 1 upon 3 by 2, that becomes 3 by 1, which is equal to 3. So now we know the slope m is equal to 3. What does that tell you? Since m is equal to 3, which means m is greater than 1. Okay, now since m is greater than 1, we know what we have to do. We have to just increment to find the next y coordinate. What we have to do? Just increment it by 1. So yk plus 1 becomes yk plus 1. Okay, now k as 1 as its starting point. Okay, because we are using it from the starting point till we reach the end part. Okay, so what we do is y 1 plus 1, that is k plus 1, is equal to y 1 plus 1. So we know what is the value of y 1 over here. You can see in the diagram what is the value of y 1. Y 1 is 1. Okay, so it becomes 1 plus 1, which is 2. So we have got the value of the y 2 coordinate, which is 2. Now we have to find the value of x 2 coordinate. How do we do it? We just use the same formula. See over here, what is the formula when m is greater than 1? Xk plus 1 is equal to xk plus 1 by m. M is the slope. What is the slope over here? We found out 3. So what is the thing that we are going to do? We are just going to substitute all the values. Xk, that is the previous x value, which in our case is 2. You can check. Okay, over here x1 is 2. So we just write 2 plus 1 by m. M is 3. So 2 plus 1 by 3, that comes approximately to 2.333334. I have written down it as 2.34. So now we have got the coordinates of x2 and y2. That is the next point. What are the coordinates? 2.34, 2. Okay. Now we know x2, y2. Let's find out x3, y3. Okay. First, let's just for simplicity or for just checking, we'll just find the slope of x2, y2 to x end, y end. Okay. What will be the slope? Y end minus y2 upon x end minus x2, which comes to 4 minus 2 upon 3 minus 2.333334, which is 2 by 0.666667, which approximately comes to 3. So slope remains constant throughout the line because it is part of the same line. You don't have to find the slope again and again. I'm just showing you. Okay. Now, since slope is greater than 1, we have to just follow the same formula. Okay. Which is yk plus 1, that is the next coordinate, which will be y3 is equal to yk plus 1. Okay. So which makes it y2 plus 1. Okay. And xk plus 1 will be xk plus 1 by m. So here k is equal to 2. So to find y3, what we have to do? y2 plus 1, and that comes to y3 is equal to, in our case y2 we got 2. Okay. So 2 plus 1, 3. So we have got the value of y3. y3 is 3. Okay. And x3, just substitute the value of x2, which is 2.34 plus 1 by m. So slope is again 3. So 2.34 plus 1 by 3. So x3 we get 2.67. Therefore, x3 comma y3 we get 2.67, 3. So this is how we get the line. Okay. 2, 1 is the starting point. 3, 4 is the ending point. K is equal to 2. That is the second point we got is 2.34, 2. And third point where K is equal to 3 is 2.67, 3. So when you pass a line through this, we get a straight line. This is the DDA line drawing algorithm. All right. That's it for today, guys. If you have any doubt, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. If you didn't understand anything, just go back in the video and watch. Okay. Share this video with your friends if you think it is going to be helpful for them. Like this video and make sure you subscribe. Thank you.